Welcome back, everyone. This is Zaid, and I am back on the Too Crafty Amplified Vanilla server. And today, I've got a couple of things to show you. Hey, I'm having trouble looking at the camera. You know what? Hey, yeah! All right, so let's see. Let's start with this. You can see my farm here. This is the farm we worked on last time. Got it all finished off and mirrored on the other side here. For now, I'm just going with two rows of wheat at the bottom, and then potatoes all the way up that side, carrots all the way up that side, and up here, I switched it. I mentioned last time I kind of thought it would be cool to see the water moving. I accomplished that. We updated the snapshot, and so now we've got the new doors and fences. So these are birch fences. Blends in pretty nicely with the white, but you can see the water go back and forth through it, so it's pretty cool. I still don't have the redstone wired all the way down to the bottom, so right now you actually have to come up here, and the levers are just chilling right there. On both sides, I'm going to wire them down through and then underneath and find a spot to put the levers over there, but I haven't done that yet. We'll get that done pretty soon. I also, over here, I carved just a little bit out of the side so that it's 1.5 tall the whole way down to keep mobs from getting in and squashing everything. So now I'm just having a little bit of trouble down there at the end. Slimes and stuff can come in and they kind of jump all over stuff, which is obnoxious, but that, other than that, not really having any more trample problems. So let's see. Today, while I'm over here, we are going to build a storage room, and we're going to do that in this hole that I dug out. I guess I didn't have enough fun digging a hole at spawn for those roads, so I decided I'd build some more giant holes in the wall, but we're going to put our storage room in there. I've also been messing around with a road, just kind of getting it going up here, experimenting with some looks. I think I like it so far, just using cobblestone stairs anytime there's a steep incline. The flat parts, I'm doing the slabs with the, just kind of, it's the diorite, polished diorite and a slab on top, so it's kind of one high, so you can still get out, but it's got a nice look to it. And then anywhere there's kind of like a turn in the stairs, I'm doing just this little thing, kind of how it is in the farm over there, with just a circle with the light in the middle. I guess it's a square and not a circle. But this is going to continue. I've kind of got it marked out. It's going to go all the way up to the very tip top of that. I'll point at that in just a second. But the thing I'm very excited about, I tweeted a picture of this already, and I got some really positive feedback, so I am going to reveal to you the banner that I have created for myself. If you weren't aware, they added banners to the game for 1.8, and they are pretty sweet. Now that mountain right there, the very top of that, there's a flat spot right there where these trees are. I don't know how well you can see that. There's a flat part up there I'm going to build there. And then there's this piece that goes up, and there's one more on the other side you can't see. I'm going to build like some little towers or something up there. It has a really cool view of the swamp that's over there. I grabbed some sheep. I found a couple by spawn, so I left a few at spawn for the others. I brought some back. I'm breeding them up. I need to find a place to put them. I needed the wool for the banners, so I've got that. We'll show you that in just a second, but let me show you where this noise is coming from. This is my friend the zombie villager. He picked up a block, so I decided to keep him. We're gonna probably do some trading with him. There's still that village just right over there, but I don't really have any minecart track yet. So unless I can find a dungeon to loot, mine shaft, and steal all of that track, it'll actually just be easier to cure this guy, especially since Paisley was kind enough to bring me some potions of weakness already, so I have that whole step skipped. I've got these right here, so just throw in a little bit of gold, which I've got half a stack of, and we can cure a couple. I just need to find one more zombie villager and decide where I want to put them, but we'll get to that later. Let me go ahead and show you this banner, and then I've got to do some cooking so we can do our storage room. Let's just put a crafting table down here. So if you aren't familiar with the banner system, basically you make them just like a sign. You just use wool instead of wooden planks, and it will create a banner of whatever color of wool you use. So here I'm using black wool, which gives me a black banner. And if I put it down right now, it's just this plain black banner. What do I break these with? An axe. Okay. And you can then make designs on them depending on where you place it and how you place dyes and different objects in here. So to make my banner, what we're going to do is we're going to take light blue, we're going to put a line down the middle, which gives us this stripe. And then we're going to put it back. And we're going to add this slash through it. You can kind of see a piece of it there, maybe. It's actually just to give a little bit of a border, just because I had an extra layer. So that gives us that. We put that on. And then we're going to add a brick, which gives the brick texture. It defaults to black. If I were to put, say, white in here, if you can see that, you see those white bricks on there. But I just want a black one because I just want to add a brick pattern to that blue stripe we have there. Then I'm going to pull that out, and if I make this X symbol, that gives us a nice big white X. And then put that in the middle and put a stripe above it, and we block the top third of the banner. Do it again on the bottom, and we block the bottom third of the banner, and we end up with this, which is hard to see there, but check this out. Sweet. So we have an X, we've got kind of the blue colors. I went for the blue and the black to match my YouTube and Twitter logo. The X, of course, is for Zade, and then by having this blue stripe in here with the brick pattern over it, it kind of creates this almost like lightning look. And then you can't really tell, but the reason that black slashes through it is it kind of just adds a little bit of a dark border around this white X. And makes it show up just a little bit better. It covers up a little bit of the brick pattern, make it look even more like lightning. And with this is our finished product. So what we need to make this, we need plenty of black sheep, which we're breeding some up there. I've got to find a place for those. I actually want to make a sheep cooker so I can just get a bunch of black wool from that. And also they drop mutton now, so I can get free food and free black wool from those to make these. The white dye is easy. I've got plenty of skeleton bones already, but there is also Anarchy is working on a skeleton grinder on the server, so bones will be a piece of cake. And villager trading, when we get into that, will give us lapis, so the light blue dye will be no problem. So all we need to do is get a sheep farm going, which we're gonna do pretty soon because I want to go get some clay anyway. So I'm gonna go over to a desert. And I know where a mesa is. I'm going to dig a tunnel over in the nether because it's pretty far. Even in the nether, it's going to be 1500 blocks. But we're going to dig over there. And I'm going to make a squid farm while I'm there, probably just because it'll be a nice dry area. And I should get plenty of squid spawns. So we'll do that. But for now, what I need to do, if you are not aware, they have added some blocks to the. Well. Have made some blocks that are already here craftable. So let me show you. First off, take some smooth stone here. One of the blocks that they have made craftable. I think I'm gonna need a couple of these. So one is the old cracked stone block. So if I cook stone brick now, we'll just go ahead. You can see it's already made into stone brick. You couldn't cook that before. We're gonna let that cook for just a second. And in the meantime, I'm gonna take a vine here. Actually, give me two vines. If you weren't aware, you can now take a stone brick and add a vine, and you can get mossy stone brick. You can also, if you make slabs and stack them, you can get the chiseled stone brick. And if you cook a stone brick, you get cracked stone brick, which is actually one of my favorite blocks in the game. And these are what we're going to be using, mostly the cracked, a little bit of the mossy, and a tiny bit of chiseled stone, along with some acacia wood, is what we're going to make the storage room out of over there. And just for fun, while I'm here, you can also take regular cobblestone with vines and now make moss stone. So we have all of these options to craft that we did not have previously, and that is pretty awesome. I'm just gonna stick that in there. And that I don't need either. So I'm gonna go ahead and cut here, and I am going to cook up a whole bunch of stone because I need a whole bunch of regular stone bricks, cracked stone bricks, a little bit of these others, and I also need to grab a little bit more netherrack because we're going to use just a little bit of nether brick. So I need to get that cooked up. So I'm going to set up just one of the old little hopper furnace combo things going on there to automatically cook some. So I'll get that taken care of. I'll get started in on the storage room, and I will come back and show you what kind of progress we're making on that and show you how that's coming along. All right, I think I've got enough stuff farmed up to at least get started. I don't think we're going to be able to quite finish this today, but we'll be able to at least show you what it is going to look like when we are finished. Let's see, I want that first. So let me just do one section here. We'll start with that. Let's move this torch out of the way. What we're going to do for chest is have a pillar of acacia wood on either side, just like that. And then I need a couple of slabs to fill in right there because there's going to be chests underneath that that we want to still be able to open. Nope. Let me think about this. Wall. Yeah. That's right. That's right. Just kidding. And then, whoops. We want just some cobble for the little bit you'll see underneath the chest there. Didn't mean to knock that block out, so we'll just do that part next. We're just going to put the cracked stone there. Behind the chest right here, we're just gonna put in some stone brick, just the regular kind. And then on either side of this little hole, we're gonna put in cracked stone, but we wanna leave just a couple of random spots. So let's maybe on this one, let's do like there, there, there. Let's kinda go like that. And then we're gonna fill it in with the mossy stone to give it a little bit of color. Make it feel a little bit older. And let's see, then right there, we put some stairs like that. And then, ooh, I didn't make any chests. Let me do that now. Each one of these will hold four double chests. And they will just go in like this. Like that. And a couple torches on either side for some lighting is how we're going to do that little section there. Let's also kind of show you how I plan to do the corners. I'm putting way too many furnaces in here, mostly as a decoration, just in the corner like that. And then we're just going to fill in the cracked stone right there. And then again at the top, we're just doing the stone brick stairs. And then, of course, there'll be another pillar right there. And then again, just a torch on either side. So that's what the corner bit is going to look like. And then this will be repeated right here and right here and right here. And then in the middle of each one, there will be a potential pathway going somewhere. Right now, it's just the entrance right here, which goes out. But I could eventually put them on all four sides if I find some other places to go. From here, we then are going to take out a row of this cracked stone again. I can just go the whole way with that, I guess, like that. And we'll go a couple right here also. And then it's going to go up one more layer. Like this. And all the way across. And then the ceiling is going to be filled in. This whole layer will be mostly cracked stone with bits of the mossy stone mixed in. And because that's going to take a little bit longer, I already went ahead and prepared this corner. So you can see all the way from the entryway to a potential hallway to somewhere else. We've got four sets of the chests and a little bit of mossy mixed in there just to give it a little kind of an old dungeony feel. Since I did dig it into the side of the mountain, I wanted it to kind of feel like a cave. So that's what I was going for here. You can see all the extra furnaces just in case, mostly for decoration. And then we've kind of got a little bit of depth going in the ceiling. We've got the stair, then a row, and then the stair, and then the whole ceiling will be filled in like this. And you can see I just already started sticking in a couple pieces of the mossy stone. I'll probably go through and put most of the ceiling in and then just kind of knock out a couple blocks here and there and fill it in with the mossy. And then on the floor, I'm doing just another row of stairs here. And then the whole floor can be half slab, so I don't have to light it up any more than I feel like it, because mobs won't actually spawn in here. I'm going with the stair, and then we're going to have the row of the nether brick just for some color. And then at this point, I'm not sure what I'm going to do in the middle here, so that's I just put in this flat for fun. Either going to have just kind of maybe. Like in here, there'd be like a little square which would have some shrubs in it and do some decorating like that. Or I was, which is what I actually originally planned, but what I was just thinking about as I was building this is potentially if I came out to and put another row in right here of the nether brick, like this, I can make a pathway all the way around the room. And then I can put in a row of stairs in right here, and I should be able to fit a square of chests that would basically be, if I'm standing right here, there'd be a wall, and if I came around here, there'd be four chests here. There'd be a path in the middle, four chests here, path in the middle with four chests here. I just have to make sure it fits. I think it will without blocking this, but I'd have to check. I think, well. I mean, I keep it can, I guess it's six. So that'd be like stair. Because I hear one, two, three, four, five, six, and a stair. It might end up cutting off these platforms. I don't know. So I'll have to play with it. It's going to either be like that, or some shrubs or something. I don't know. We'll figure it out during the week sometime. Probably during a stream or something. And we'll show you next time. And then these banners. I just have two crafted right now because I need to farm a whole bunch of black ink. They are going to go all the way around the room, unless it ends up looking like too much, on every single one of these pillars. All the way around. We'll see how it looks when it's done. I don't know. It might end up being too many. If it is too many, I'll probably take off the. Where do I hit this? Ah, give me my banner. There we go. I'll probably take them off these, and at least for now, while I don't have the stuff, I'll just have them on kind of the sides of the pathways. So I don't know. Let me know what you think. Let me know if it would be too much in the middle there. Let me know what you think of the storage room concept and all of that. If you have any suggestions, let me know, because I'm still going to be building this, so it'd be a great time for improvements. And that's going to be it for today. Hopefully, this will be largely done by next episode. And I can get started on. Let's see, we need an ink farm pretty soon. We need some villager trading pretty soon. We need a lot of stuff. I don't know what we'll do. We'll see next week. Thanks for watching, everyone. Please leave a like if you enjoyed the video and subscribe if you're not already and you would like to see more. That's a great way to be alerted about my new videos. And as always, if you have any comments at all, leave them. Below the video, whether it's related to the video, random jokes, venting, just saying hello, whatever, go for it. Have a great week, everyone. I'll see you next time. Bye bye.